Hey guys, Corey here. I'm here in Cedar Park, Texas, getting ready to do some cleaning here. Anyway, I'm a dealer for Challenger. I've had this channel since 2017. If you're interested in starting a small business and you want to learn how to clean carpet, this channel is dedicated to the small guy, to the one-man show, you know, that can teach you how to clean carpet, do it very effectively, and can teach you how to do it very cheaply with minimal equipment and the most minimal of cleaning products. There's video after video about this on this channel, but I continue to make videos about it, and then I have to make videos to update what's been changed and videos to catch everybody new up to kind of where we're at in the channel here. Right here I'm using, actually I've added baking soda to my mix to see if I feel like it makes a difference. I don't really know that it will. This carpet's not all that soil. I've got one room sprayed and a little section of hallway here. Now, let me show you how I'm starting.
Over there is what I've basically got in my mix. I've got two of these guys mixed up. I've got a healthy shot. And again, I do everything by the seat of my pants. I don't measure anything. This is a mix of two capfuls of plant-based Tide, one capful of OxiClean. I don't know exactly which one the OxiClean it is. It's in the video I put up. Healthy shot of clear volume 20, which is 6% hydrogen peroxide, and 2 tablespoons of pure baking soda and a shot of LA's Totally Awesome. This is stuff cleans carpet like crazy, and it cost a whole dollar. Saw it on a shelf for years and never thought about trying it until really successful cleaner out of New York mentioned it to me, and figured, okay, well, I can believe him. I'll try it then. I'll try it. So I've got this room, that room sprayed up to right here. A lot of times you'll see me doing a pre-scrub with either a white pad, or I've got these different pads that have a scrubbing stripe in them, which basically looks like AstroTurf. This carpet, it doesn't need it. So we're just gonna run basically the pad, and we're gonna polish the fibers with the peroxide here in this particular one. So I'm gonna do this one. I'm gonna come back and look at it, and then I'm gonna spray this one, and you can watch me clean this one. This looks like probably the dirtiest carpet in the whole house here, but I'm going to pass on doing the pre-scrub on this as well. It might could actually use it. We'll see if I change my mind before I might just go ahead and pre-scrub this one. Anyway, I'm gonna take care of that one first and we'll have a look. All right, I put the striped scrub pad underneath it here. It doesn't do a good job of extracting, but it does a very good job of scrubbing the carpet and getting it ready for extraction. It's almost to the point that it's faster to do a pre-scrub and then extract than it is to try to do it all with just the extraction. So here we go. I need to take a 9/16 screenshot and tighten some screws here on my machine. It's starting to vibrate a little bit when you use this particular pad on it. It's heavy.
using my regular tripod today. Got my bigger fancy one. I left my old one, the one that works better at someone's house apparently. Anyway, see if I can get this guy a little closer to the carpet maybe. Anyway, you can tell where I've scrubbed and where I haven't. I cut the room in half here. Now when I come through with the regular white pad that I use, I'll be able to extract the soil much easier than if I had to break through it with that same soft towel and do the extraction. So this guy, it's got these, it's very abrasive as is, and it's got these dark blue stripes in it, which are made out of like AstroTurf. So it's microfiber and AstroTurf together. It does do extracting, but not that well. It does scrubbing much better. So it's kind of basically for the pre-scrub mainly. I bought them thinking they were gonna do really good cleaning, and it turns out they don't clean that well, but they scrub like crazy for a pre-scrub. So that's what they're used for mainly on this channel. I've got a job coming up at a poker place on Saturday. I may or may not use them there, I don't know. Depends on its commercial carpet. We'll see how soiled it is and whether or not it needs it. Change out, put the white pad on it. So I will change that out, be right back. All right, we're gonna take a look at that pad after I get done. Should have some decent soil on it, because this room has a majority of soil.
full house. So, and this pad will be a lot quieter on the machine. Half the room is done here, the other half. There we go. Looks like it's going to work now.
Thank you.
your soil. I get more out of that, actually.
Now we're gonna move everything and I'm gonna groom it. I'm gonna pick up the machine and move it, and we'll groom it for the crowd that likes grooming.
All right.
It's grooming now.
Pick up the video upstairs. We'll do room by room upstairs. All right. That turned out really well. Wasn't one of the fun ones to make where you turn it night to day or anything, but this is, even when a frisée is lightly soiled, it can be harder than any other carpet, heavily soiled. I'll check back in upstairs. All right, now we're upstairs. This is gonna be all before and after cleaning here. Not heavily soiled at all. It's got heavy wear, but not heavily soiled. Through there, it's very soft and got a lot of wear, so it was sucking up to the vacuum when I was going through there. So do this one first, and then I'll do these two over here. So I got text coming in from people in the carpet done, and I'm trying to record and clean this carpet, and thanks for a busy day. All right. When we check back over this one, it'll be done. So here we go. Won't be a world of difference because it's not that dirty, but it'll look nicer for sure. All right, take a look over here. This guy's done, it's groomed. Now, I got this area, I sprayed half a hole here, so I did that. Now I'm going into this room here to do it. Do this guy right quick and groom it. And I'll come out here and I'll do this one. And the other half of the hall here. And then stairs. I'm gonna leave the stairs out. Stairs, I don't feel like I make good video myself. Okay, we're all done up here. Like I said, I'm gonna leave the stairs out of this whole equation and get done and get out of here. And we'll just leave the stairs completely out of it. Everything's groomed. I gotta kind of groom my way out of here once I get everything downstairs and then do the stairs. And I kind of groove my way right out of the door, so I let them put the first footprints on the whole place. But it turned out well. It wasn't one of the jobs that I turned night into day or anything, but you know, it all turned out well. It wasn't heavily soiled, but this carpet is the most difficult to bring back whenever it is heavily soiled. And this room was the one that had all the soil in it. All right, guys, signing off on this one here. If you're interested in buying a Challenger, you can text me. The number is 512-350-1129. It's in most of the videos. If not, it's really easy to find. What I do is, you know, I get a commission check from Challenger for, you know, introducing the equipment to people. So what I do is I send you a $100 thank you, basically, out of that check that I get. And you're welcome to text me with all your questions and stuff that you have from that point on. I do most of my helping of people through text because I don't really talk on the phone very much anymore at all. I book all of my jobs via text and everything, and even the ones that come in on email, I turn them into text. I track everything. I tell people on text, you know, and I just feel like it works out better that way. I'm not prone to long conversation on the phone at this point anymore, not at this point in my life. Anyway, I appreciate you guys watching. Like, share the video. This channel is growing at a pretty good rate now. You know, it's a boring subject for most people, but the people that watch it, you know, are trying to learn how to better their lives and learn how to do a new trade. And I'm the one that tends to help you with basically no strings attached. Not trying to shove some product down your throat that you don't want or need. Thanks for watching, guys. God bless.